Yesterday we saw that given to us sides AB and Okay. So yesterday we saw that sides AB and AC of triangle ABC are produced to point E and D. So we have produced this side AB and AC to point E and D. You can see it like this. If you are not able to visualize, you can make a separate diagram for this thing like this: A, B, C, E, and D. Okay. This question is a little bit complicated, so please be concentrated on the question only. Now, if BO and CO are bisectors of angle CBE and BCD, so this BO, like this, we have BO, which is bisector of this angle. That means these two are equal. Similarly, CO, that is this line, is bisector of this angle. So these two are also equal. Now, it is saying prove that angle BOC, that is this angle BOC, this angle is equal to 90 degree minus half angle BAC, that is this angle. So yesterday we have already named all these. So we have the given part with us: angle A is equal to angle B, we know. Angle C is equal to angle D, already given to us. We have to prove that angle BOC, which is angle E is equal to 90 degree minus half angle BAC, that is angle X. So we started with two things that we know. There are two triangles, we can use angle sum property for sure. So we write like this: proof in triangle A, B, C, we can say angle X plus angle Y plus angle Z is equal to 180 degree by ASP of triangle. First thing that we wrote yesterday, it is your equation number one. Similarly, we wrote in triangle BOC, we can say angle B plus angle E plus angle C is equal to how much? 180 degree, same reason. Now, after this, we had a problem. Our two proof part is having E from the lower triangle and X from the upper triangle. So we discussed yesterday, we need to find a relation between these two triangles so that we can make them in a same statement. Right now, X is in upper statement. Right now, X angle is in the equation one and E angle is in the equation number two. We have to think how we can bring them together in one equation. One second, Chris is there. Okay, to bring them together in one equation, we yesterday thought that why not we use this angle complete as the external angle. We can say this is the external angle and it is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. Yes, class, can't we say this is the exterior angle? If this is a triangle, obviously this is the extended side and this is the angle formed on the exterior side. This is your exterior angle, which is equal to sum of interior opposite angles, that is these two. If we use this thing, we can bring a relation between above and below triangles. So let's start. We can say in triangle ABC that angle A plus B, you can see complete external angle is A plus B only. So we can say angle A plus angle B is equal to angle X plus angle Z. So what I have done is I have taken the exterior angle equal to sum of interior opposite angles. Property is exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. We can write the reason as exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. This is the property. Similarly, we can write also C plus D, that is, this is also exterior angle. This is equal to how much? This angle and this angle. So again, we are taking the other side, that is C plus D. So angle C plus angle D is equal to angle X plus angle Y. Again, the same reason. So we have taken both the exterior angles. Now, we have to think in above two equations, that is 1 and 2. We have all these variables except, please tell me which two variables are not there. I think A and D are not there. Please confirm. Equation 1 and 2, which two variables are not there? Please confirm. In equation 1 and 2, which two variables are not there? E is not there. But E is there already, Ansh. You can see this A and D are extra. A and D are not used over there. Yes, Abhishek. So we have to eliminate A and D. We know A and B are equal and C and D are equal. Again, I'm repeating. We had these two relations. We found this from our side that exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angles. In this case, this A is not used in above equations and this D is also not used in the equations. So what we can do is we can replace them with their equivalent part. We can say, angle B plus angle B is equal to angle X plus angle Z because A is equal to B, we know, and angle C plus angle C is equal to angle X plus angle Y. Same reason, because C is equal to B. One second, what do you want to say? We can change with X. Huh, but I will change. So now we have got the values as twice angle B is equal to angle X plus angle Z and twice angle C is equal to angle X plus angle Y. Now we have got value of angle B and angle C. We can put it in equation number 2. We have angle B here and angle C over here. But before that, we have twice of B and twice of C. So first of all, multiply equation 2 by 2. So it becomes twice angle B plus twice angle E plus twice angle C is equal to 180 degree into 2, that is 360 degree. Now we have value of twice angle B, that is X plus Z. We have twice angle E as it is, and 2C can be written as angle X plus angle Y is equal to 360 degree. So till now what I have done is I have used above equations to bring together X and E. My main motive in the two proof part was X and E. Please tell me, any doubts till now? Sir, but how will we understand that we have to do these steps? But Vaishnav, that is why I'm telling you, na? You have to see the two proof part again and again. The two proof part is saying loudly that I want a relation between X and E only. That is why I am going in that direction. In all these questions of two proof, you have to see what is given to you and what you want to find. Okay. I'm again explaining. See, we knew these two equations, that sum of these three angles and these three angles is 180 degree. We found from our side that A plus B is equal to X plus Z and C plus D equal to X plus Y. After that, we made this B plus B, that is 2B is equal to this thing and 2C equal to this thing. First tell me, is this thing clear to you? How I found this? Tell me this. Is it clear to you? How I found this relation? Ansh, please tell. Okay. Others, confirm. So those who are saying, sir, how will we understand? We have to do this. You just have to think of one that you have upper triangle, you have a lower triangle. You want a relation between upper angle X and lower angle E. To bring that relation into existence, you have to think of a connecting link. That connecting link, which will talk with both the countries, is angle B and angle C, because they are part of exterior angle. Okay, so you have to think like that. Now, after this, what I have done is, I have taken equation number 2. Equation 2 was B plus E plus C. I have values of 2B and 2C. So what I have done, from my side, I have multiplied equation 2 with 2. So it became twice of angle B plus twice of angle E plus twice of angle C equal to 360 degree. Now our work is done. We are very close to our destination. Okay. So now what we have done is, putting the value of twice angle B is X plus Z. Twice E is as it is. Twice C can be written as X plus Y. Now we know value of X, Y and Z is how much? Please tell me, what is the value of X plus Y plus Z? What is the value of X plus Y plus Z? Yes, Ananya, good. Piyush, no, not 60. Ishan, correct. Yovika, oh good, beta. Vaishnav, Jasnur. Now you, all of you are getting this, good. Now, again, you are thinking, sir, why you are thinking that way? My two proof part has only two variables, angle E and angle X. So I have to get rid of Z and Y. To get rid of Z and Y, I thought like this. Why not? I see like this. X plus Z plus Y becomes how much? 180 degree plus twice angle E plus angle X equal to 360 degree. Now you can see, we are very close to our two proof part. We have got E, X and our value of angle in the same equation. Now we just have to solve this and we'll get the answer. Let's see. Let me drop this first. One second. I know it is not that easy to understand, but if you think over it, it is very easy. One second. Now, after getting this, we can say twice of angle E plus angle X is equal to 360 minus 180. Further, it becomes twice angle E plus angle X equal to 180 degree. And finally, twice of angle E is equal to 180 minus angle X. And last, 2 will be in division. 180 upon 2 is 90 degree minus angle X upon. So we have finally found the relation between X and angle E. So just need to understand what was the steps. First step was what we knew, where we started, the two triangles, ASP property. After that, second step, how to link them. Second step was how to link these two triangles. To link them, what came to our help was the property that exterior angle equal to sum of interior opposite angles. Third step was to put those values in the above equations and solve to get the answer. This was the logic behind this. Confirm if it is okay. Please confirm. Sir, we can find by substituting B plus C equal to 180. But you can try. There are many ways to do this. Okay. You can try this. No issue. If you're getting the answer with using this, you can take this also. I hope it's clear to all of you. Still, if you have issue, this lecture is being recorded. You can see it one more time on the YouTube and it will be clear to you. Okay. Now, let's start with the questions of exercise. Good, Bhavya. 6.3. I got a doubt. Question number 2. One second. Am I having that question number? Yes. How it became 90 degree? Ayush, okay. Beta Ayush, we had this twice angle E equal to 180 degree. When you take this 2 to the right hand side, it will come in division. Hai na? let me show you again. When you take this 2 to the right hand side, it becomes 180 minus x upon 2. Finally, when you divide, it becomes 90 minus x upon 2. Sir, I'm not able to see your screen, Drishti. But you can just leave and join again. Okay, Drishti, leave and join again. First, let's see question number 2. Aaron, please see question number 2. Okay, question number 2. In figure 6.40, a figure was there. Okay. What was the figure? 6.40. Okay, this was a figure. Okay. Angle XYZ. Before that, let me make a triangle for you. The triangle is. This is the triangle. One second. This is X. X, Y, and Z. Given to us is Y, O, and Z O are bisectors. Like this, Y O and Z O are the bisectors. That means these two angles are equal and these two angles are equal. Apart from this, they are saying angle X is 62 degree. This angle is given to us as 62 degree. Apart from this angle, okay, X, Y, Z. This complete angle, X, Y, Z. This complete angle is given to you as how much? 54 degree. Okay. You have to find angle. Find angle OZY. OZY. Let me call it A. We have to find angle A and angle YOZ. YOZ. We have to find angle B also. To find angle A and B. And what is given to us? Given to us is, suppose this is angle C. Angle C is given to us as 62 degree. Apart from this, if you take AB, this is C, this is D, this is E. We know angle D plus angle E is equal to 54 degree. And this is suppose F. Now, tell me, how will you find this? Which angle to take first? Sir, by ASP we can find, okay? So not showing the figure. I hope all of you are able to see the figure. Just know you can just take. If you are not able to see, just join again. Okay. So we have to find angle A and B. Please help me, how will you find? First tell me, what is the value of angle D and E? First, tell me what is the angle value of angle D and angle E. Class, tell me what is the value of angle D and angle E. This is angle E. We know angle X, Y, Z is 54 degree. What is value of angle D and angle E? Class, please respond. Hello. Are you able to hear me, class? Okay. Now you're giving 27. Prisha is saying 180 minus 54. No. Piyush 60. No, beta. Jasnoor 54 only. Utkarsh correct. Ayush, no, beta. 54 degree is the complete angle, beta. See again. this is given to you, angle X, Y, Z is 54 degree. We have a bisector of this angle. So we have named this part as angle D, this part as angle E. Yes, now you are correct, Gulin, Bhavya, Abhishek, Aaron. Ayush, are you getting this? It is D plus E equal to 54 degree. Okay, they both are equal. Yes, Ayush, now you are correct. So we can say in the proof part that angle D plus angle E is equal to 54 degree. Given to us, we can say it is twice, sorry, like this you can write, angle D plus angle D is equal to 54 degree. Reason is angle D is equal to angle E. Finally, we get angle D is equal to 54 upon 2, that is 27 degree. Bhuvan Jyot, not 37, it is 27. Okay, so we have got angle D and angle E. Now tell me, how will you find the remaining? Yes, class, we know this angle 62, we know 54 degree. We can find this angle very easily, A plus F. So in triangle in triangle XYZ, we can say angle X plus angle Y plus angle Z is equal to 180 degree by angle sum property. Now put the values, X is how much? 62 degree. Y is how much? 54 degree. Z is unknown. Now solve it. Z is equal to how much? 180 minus 62 minus 54. What is the value of Z? Please tell. What is the value of Z? 64. Bhuvan Jyot saying 74. Okay, most are saying it is 64. Let's check. It will be 180 minus 2 plus 4 is 6. 6 plus 5 is 11. So 10 minus 6 is 4. 7 minus 1 is 6. So we have got angle Z equal to 64 degree. Same thing. Here also, angle Z is made up of two angles, A and F. So we can say angle R, angle A plus angle F equal to 64 degree. They both are equal. We can say angle A plus angle A is equal to 64 degree. Finally, angle A is equal to 64 upon 2, 32 degree. So we have got angle A as 32 degree. We have got angle E as 27 degree. Can't we find angle B now? Yes, class. We have found the two angles which are inside. Can't we find angle B now? Same reason, we will go for angle sum property. Now, in triangle YOZ, angle E plus angle B plus angle A is equal to 180 degree. Put these values. E is how much? 27. B is how much? Unknown. A is 32. Now solve it. You get the answer as 180 degree minus 7 plus 2 is 9. 2 plus 3 is 5. And the answer is Utkarsh saying 121. Yuvika 121. Bhavya 121. So answer is 121. So we have got angle B and angle A both. I hope Aaron, it is clear to you now. The thing is, you have to understand what you can find directly and what you have to find indirectly. Aaron, is it clear better? Okay. Now, next out, please ask in which question? D plus E plus A plus F. D plus E plus A plus F is equal to angle B. No. How you are saying? By excellent theorem. Moksh, you can try. By excellent theorem, you can try. But I don't think it will give answer. You can try. So last question of the exercise, okay? Doubt in question number 6, Mishti saying, sir, it is a property of triangle. Okay, Moksh, you can try. Okay? And share with me the solution. Question number 5. Saying, okay. So let's take question 5 now. Question 5. Here we are. Question number 3, Ansh. Ansh, question number 3, let me take in the book only. Once again, I'm just giving you the hint for question number 3, it is an easy question. You have to use your thinking level, then only you will be able to understand these questions. Okay. Question number 3. Okay. Question number 3 is saying, in figure 6.41, that is this figure, AB is parallel to DE. This line AB and DE are parallel. Angle BAC is given to you. BAC is how much? 35 degree, this angle. Angle CDE is given to you as 53. We have to find DCE. You have to find this angle. Okay, let me take it again. Actually, time is less now. I wanted to cover other questions also. No issue. A, B. This is given as 35 degree. This is given as 53 degree. Now, to find this angle, Ansh, we want this angle. Can you tell me what is the value of this angle? Ansh, can you tell me what is the value of B? Yes. We can find B very easily by a simple property. When there are two lines parallel and one transversal, we can observe this 35 and this angle B are forming alternate interior angles. So this is how much? 35 degree only. And after that, we will apply angle sum property in this triangle to get the last angle. I hope it is clear now, Ansh. So now you can find easily. Yes, that's good. Okay. Now let's see question number 5. All questions are easy in this exercise. Just have to think a little bit. Okay, question 5. Let's see. In this question, this figure is not, it is extra over here, just came with the cutting. Now, question is saying, if PQ is perpendicular to PS, this PQ is perpendicular to PS, that is, this angle is how much? 90 degree given to us. So, first thing is, suppose I take it as A. So, first thing given, angle A is equal to 90 degree. Then they are saying PQ is parallel to SR. Again, write it down. PQ parallel to SR. Angle SQR, that is, this angle is given to you. Name it as B. Angle B is given to you as 28 degree. Then they are saying angle QRT. QRT. Name it as angle C. So angle C is given to you as 65 degree. Then find the values of X and Y. To find angle X and angle Y. Now tell me, class, which triangle you will consider first? Tell me which triangle you will consider first. So last question was 6th. No, beta, it was question number 3, last one. 6 I will do. First you will find X. Y, I'm saying. First you will find Y, okay. QRS. Yes, beta. Good. We will go for using alternate interior angles. Okay. Goldin saying QSR. Okay. Goldin, how will you find QSR directly? I am asking which angle we can find directly right now. Is there any angle that we can find directly? Alternate interior angles. So we'll find X first. Okay. Okay, beta, you are correct now. We can find X first because that is the starting link. This angle 65 degree, that is, this is equal to how much? Can we say C equal to X as alternate interior angles? Yes, class. Aaron and Ayush are correct. Utkarsh correct, beta. We cannot say no, Jasnoor. X and C are not equal. X plus 28 is equal to C. You have to understand. Yes, Bhavya, you are correct now. X plus 28 is the complete angle. It is equal to how much? 65 degree. So we can say from the figure that angle X plus 28 degree is equal to 65 degree because alternate interior angle. This gives me a value of X equal to how much? Bhavya saying 37. Others please confirm. Value of angle X, 37 only. Very good. So we have found X. Now, in triangle P, QS in triangle PQS, if you observe, you have got value of X, you have got value of A. Can't you find value of Y? Just by ASP, we can say angle A plus angle X plus angle Y is equal to 180 by the property of ASP. Now putting the values, A is 90 given to us, X we have found already 37, Y is unknown. I hope you can find this very easily. Yes? So Y equal to 28. But please confirm what is the answer. All are saying it is 53. Better check, Mishti. Just solve the equation, you will get the answer. Okay? Now, all of you, last 2 minutes are left. We will discuss last question tomorrow. I want to give you a hint. You have to use exterior angle theorem in that and you can solve it. Okay? Tomorrow we'll discuss that. Please switch on your camera.